In this lecture, we shall discuss about the packing fraction curve and binding fraction curve. The packing fraction curve arises from this relation, where F is packing fraction, M atomic mass, and A is the mass number. When we plot the packing fraction against the mass number, we get the curve this. Look at the curve carefully. The helium atom, carbon atom, and oxygen atom do not follow this curve. The packing fraction of these atoms are small, so these atoms are stable. Look, the mass number greater than 20, the packing fraction becomes negative, and it attains the minimum value when the mass number is about 60. Further, if we increase the mass number, the packing fraction is increasing. Mass number greater than 180, the packing fraction becomes positive further. Now, what will be the conclusion of this curve? The elements with the mass number never 45 have lowest packing fraction with negative value. So, the elements with mass number round about 45 are highly stable, and the mass number greater than 180, where the packing fraction is positive, the elements will be unstable, and when the mass number greater than 230, the elements are radioactive and undergo disintegration spontaneously. Now we are going to discuss about the binding fraction curve. This curve is actually the variation of the binding energy per nucleon with respect to the mass number. In this curve, we find that for very light nuclei, the binding energy per nucleon is very small, and due to increment of the mass number of the nucleus, firstly, the binding energy per nucleon increases very rapidly and attains the value 8 MeV per nucleon at mass number A equal to 20. And further increment of the mass number, the binding energy per nucleon attains the maximum value 8.79 MeV per nucleon at the mass number 56. For higher mass number, the binding energy per nucleon is decreases slowly. Now come to the point for heavy nuclei. The nuclei with mass number greater than 180, the binding energy per nucleon decreases monotonically with increase of the mass number. For the heaviest nuclei, the value of FB will be 7.5 MeV per nucleon. Now look, the 8 MeV per nucleon attains at the mass number 20, and for heaviest nuclei A greater than 180, the value of FB decreases monotonically. Then for the Mach number between 20 and 180, the variation of FB with Mach number is very slight from here to here, so that it may be taken the approximately constant. In this region, the mean value of FB will be 8.5 MeV per nucleon. Now, for very light nuclei, we also find the fluctuation in this curve. This is the fluctuation. In particular, peaks are observed in the curve for the even nuclei that are helium, barium, and carbon, etc. Similar but less prominent peaks are observed at the values of proton or neutron equal to 20, 28, 50, 82, and 126. These are known as the magic numbers. Now we will discuss about the curve of the number of neutrons varies as the number of protons for the stable nuclei. This is the nature of the curve. It is evident from the curve that for light nuclei whose atomic number smaller than 20, the stability curve is straight line with n equal to z. Secondly, for heavier nuclei z greater than 20 as well as n greater than 20, the stability line bends the direction n greater than z. Now, why the stability curve depart more and more from z equal to n line as z increases? Look, for large z, the Coulomb electrostatic repulsion becomes important and the number of neutrons must be greater to compensate this repulsive effect. Look at this curve. This curve is plotted with the number of the neutrons required to maximum stability versus the atomic number. Here we show the region of stability. All the stable nuclei fall in the shaded region. The nuclei above and below the shaded region are unstable. The artificial radioactive nuclei lie at the fringe of the region of stability. For the nuclei whose neutron number and proton number ratio greater than 1.5 5 are highly unstable. Those nuclei emit alpha and beta particles spontaneously and try to reach a stable configuration.